Welcome children to the maths lecture where we have solved miscellaneous problem set 2. The complete problem set we have solved. Now 3 more questions are there which are multiple choice question. Now even if they are multiple choice question, we will solve them as sum. So if it is asked in the examination, you can be able to solve the sum. So we will solve the sum. Okay. So see the first question. If the average of the numbers 33, 34, 35, x, 37, 38, 39 is 36, what is the value of the x? Means they have given you 7 numbers, in that one number they have not given. And instead of that number, they have given the average of all these numbers. So what is the number that we have to calculate? So as we know, average means average is equal to sum of all the numbers. So let me write all the numbers. 33 plus 34 plus 35 plus x plus 37 plus 38 plus 39 upon how many numbers? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now in this sum average is given, so I can write therefore 36, average is given as 36 is equal to, I find the total of all this plus x, so I get the total as 216 plus x upon 7. So therefore 216 plus x is equal to 36 multiplied by 7. Okay, this will get as 36 multiplied by 7. So that we will get as 216 plus x is equal to, what is the 7, 6 are 42, 2 carried 4, 7, 3 are 21 and 4, 25. Therefore x is equal to 252 minus 216, which gives us answer as 36. So the value of x is 36. So this number x is 36. This way you have to find the children, find it out. These both get multiplied. Okay. So I think you have got the answer. First sum. Okay. Now let us move on to the second sum. Second sum, the difference of the squares 61 square minus 51 square is equal to dash. So you have to find the difference. 61 square minus 51 square. So we can write this as 61 square minus 51 square. Can be written as children, or using formula first I'll write. This is same as the third expansion formula, that is a square minus b square is equal to a plus b multiplied by a minus b. So I can write 61 square minus 51 square is equal to 61 plus 51 into 61 minus 51. So this gives me answer as 61 plus 51 is how much? 212 multiplied by 61 minus 51 is 10. Correct children? So this gives me answer as 1220. So this is the answer of this expansion. okay? Very simple sum. But you have to use the formula and do the sum. Okay? Now let us see the third question. Let us move on to third question. If rupees 2600 are divided between Sameer and Smita in the proportion 8:5, the share of each is dash and dash respectively. So you have to find the share only. And both of them have, we have to divide this 2600 among Sameer and Smita, but in the ratio of 8:5. So how much amount they will get? So we have to find that answer. Third answer. Third one. We will write, let Sameer share. Let Sameer's share. Sameer's share is how much, children? 8. B. Rupees 8x. And second one is who? Smita. Smita's share B rupees, how much it is? 5x. Total amount is equal to rupees 2600. Therefore, 8x plus 5x is equal to 2600. Therefore, 8 plus 5 is 13x equals 2600. Therefore, x is equal to 2600 upon 13, which gives answer 200. So therefore, Sameer's share is equal to 8x is equal to 8 into 200 is equal to rupees 1600, and Smita's share is equal to 3x is equal to 3 into 200 is equal to rupees 600. How much? 600. So share of it is 5x, no? 5. Share of Smita is 5 and not 3. 5x is equal to 5 into 200 is equal to rupees 1000. Okay, so share of Sameer is 1600 rupees and share of Smita is 1000. Total gives you 2600. So by this, children, we have completed maths portion. We have also completed complete miscellaneous problem set. Also multiple choice question we have completed. Now next lecture we will be seeing the revision. Okay. So learn all the things properly. Thank you.